Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Niemeyer, and this time out, we are watching two more episodes of Power Rangers Dino Thunder. This time out, we are watching Leader of the Whack and Burning at Both Ends. So we're going to jump right into our first episode, and we're going to be doing that here in 3, 2, 1, go. Leader of the Whack was the 15th episode of Power Rangers Dino Thunder. It first aired on May 15th, 2004, written by John Telligen and directed by Andrew Merrifield. Armageddon. Not really, I'm just kidding.
I gotta get further away. It's not safe.
How far do you have to go?
Oh, I knew I shouldn't have worn heels.
I tried to tell you.
I never thought that being a field reporter meant actually standing in a field.
Well, tell me again why we're out here.
That's a good point.
I've been doing some research, and as it turns out, nearly every evil anti-hero lives somewhere in a secluded cave or somewhere outside the city.
Oh, so you think we're gonna find the White Ranger out here?
Precisely, and I'll get the interview of a lifetime.
Yeah, or he'll eat us for lunch.
Yeah, it could be Batman too, you know.
Be the White Ranger. Hold it there, White Ranger!
Ooh.
No, Cass, don't worry. It's just Trent.
Oh.
Man, you scared me half to death.
Whatever, I thought you were the White Ranger.
Yeah.
That's the third time they've run into him.
You're kidding, right?
Since he became the White Ranger.
I think you were the White Ranger. I thought that.
What the heck was
that? It's like the same explosion that they use at the intro to Mystic Force.
Grab your camera.
Can we wait? Could be dangerous.
Danger's my middle name.
How safe is it to do that in the... Ew, Agnes? How safe is it to do an explosion like that in the middle of the forest, or woods?
On a breakaway. Haley, one more level and I break my all-time record.
Oh, that's evil!
Sorry.
Now we have to start all over.
Yeah, this is... great new thing called the outdoors. You might want to check it out.
Oh, he's gonna, like he's trying to help.
Checking out the library.
Ooh.
You got about as much chance of seeing that as seeing Kira at a fashion show.
Do you really?
Dang.
Yikes. Hey, any luck on defossilizing Dr. O?
Not yet. I just can't find an energy source that can safely break the molecular bonds of the amber.
Hey, maybe we have something.
That's weird. The satellite's picking up a strange reading in the forest.
Let's go take a look.
Zantrax, report.
My lord, if my calculations are correct, Rohobot will be the most aggressive creature we have ever created.
Rohobot?
We'll see about that.
Did he call it Rohobot? Yes, the scariest, strongest monster ever.
Rohobot?
He did say Rohobot. That's a weird name.
My lord, I'm picking up heat signatures and radiation from the forest.
What kind of radiation?
Like nothing on record.
Hmm. Send that creature to retrieve it.
Oh no!
He should be able to handle that.
As you wish, my lord.
Oh no!
We're the first on the scene. This is hot. There it is! Devon, start rolling!
It really is hot.
Oh, it's harmless. Get a close up.
How can you tell?
You sure, Cass?
It's glowing.
Good on camera, though.
What do you think it is?
It's reacting to that.
Tramp?
What are you guys doing here?
I'm about asking the same thing. Haven't seen you around for a while.
Yeah, we really need to catch up.
Oh.
Not now, guys.
Kira's right. Let's check this thing out.
Pardon me, but I don't think I'm supposed to let you do that.
Oh! Not a good thing. And pteranodons too. That's all of a sudden. And they can't morph.
Creatures like that's news in this town. Let's get out of here.
Okay.
Oh, maybe they can morph. Oh, that did something.
You want my help or not?
If it's all the same, I'll just watch from over here.
That's a good idea. Well, that's cool. We haven't seen him fight yet. Unmorphed, I mean. Ooh! Caught him in the flip! Oh, but they finished it for him. Nice jump, too.
From that rock, and it's really freaky. Get away from it. It's a little late for that.
What a strange little rock.
Uh-oh. That doesn't look good.
I want a piece of the action.
Ooh. Oh!
Come on, you imps. Put him up.
Interesting. Where's Trent? Is that an exposed brain on that thing? Oh, there he is. He just got hit. Oh, it's doing something again. What?
Altercation? I was just getting started. I wanted to annihilate that goon.
Wait, what?
I got dirt under my nails. That's like totally disgusting.
Hey, where's Trent?
Guys, head back to the lab. I have some news about the space rock.
Space rock?
It's actually a meteor fragment.
Fascinating. It must have broken off during some sort of intergalactic collision.
Maybe.
I'm just afraid coming in such close proximity to it might have some strange side effects. Do you guys feel okay?
Well, I for one am going home. If I don't soak my cuticles in an aloe bath, my nails will never grow out.
I gotta hit the gym. Need to work on my pecs.
I want to get home to watch that documentary on the Great Pyramids.
Uh-huh.
Looks fascinating.
Wait, what?
Uh-oh.
They're a little too late.
I don't know what's happened to you, but I like it. Maybe I will give you another chance.
I knew it. I knew he was a fearsome warrior.
Oh, yeah.
I have a feeling things in Reefside are about to change.
What? Oh! He's John Travolta. And just happens to be passed by a woman with a giant afro, like it's the 70s.
If we could, like, go for a soda.
Well, I've got to go and catch that White Ranger fiend, but I guess one soda won't kill me. Now, where'd I park my whip?
What?
What's up, Haley?
Ethan, are you sure you feel okay?
Well, at least he's not into the game anymore. Those are kind of small.
It's particularly pleasant today. Excessively low humidity. Whatever, bro. How do my arms look? Am I ripped or what?
Not really.
Hello.
Whoa!
Sorry I'm late. There was a sale and I just, well, you understand.
Hey, you guys think I'm ready for the Iron Man competition?
Okay.
No.
There are definitely side effects from you being exposed to the meteor. We need to destroy that rock and get you guys back to normal.
Huh? Side effects. I find that highly improbable.
Yeah. I feel like I could kick Mezogod's butt myself.
That's gonna have to wait. Look who's back.
Ready.
This is good. Watch Kira. I love it. Jeez. Jump was weird too.
Let's devise a strategy of attack. I got a strategy. We crush him.
The lines on my suit are so completely wrong. Why doesn't anyone make superhero costumes for Petite?
Colorful athletes, prepare to be destroyed.
Huh?
Oh.
That was totally uncalled for. Kira, a hand?
I just know I'm gonna have the worst helmet hair after this.
Wow. That's not going well.
I told you we should have thought this out. In my business, you go big or you go home.
Well, I say we go to the mall.
Have fun. Later.
This is really weird. Whoa. Really?
Clear my booth.
Wait, he's already got a booth? I mean, come on. The whole world hasn't changed, just him. Oh, and he's pulled a Fonzie.
So, when are you going to track down the evil White Ranger, Devin?
Right after I put you on the dance floor.
Okay. Don't understand why they're all captivated by this. I would think that him looking like that would still make him like a weirdo. Oh, they just got there.
What now? I was having a super intense workout, and I was right in the middle of a very compelling biography.
Is this gonna involve dirt? Because if it does, I'm gonna have to say, Sorry I interrupted your busy day. I just thought you might like to know I think I found a way to unfossilize Dr. Oliver.
Really?
Really?
No way.
The meteor fragment. My theory is that it frees your inner self. That's why you guys are acting so weird.
Of course. If you could harness its power, you could free Dr. Oliver from the inside out. Although, I do take offense at being called weird.
Sorry, you're not being weird. It's just that the rock is allowing you to show a side of yourself that you don't usually show.
A recessive personality trait.
You could say that. Like Connor, there's a part of you that's intelligent, studious.
Ethan, there's a part of you that's athletic, even competitive. So that's why Trent helped us. There's still a part of him that's really good.
I still don't get any of this.
You don't have to. For now, just pull it.
Yeah, but Trent hasn't been seen since he got hit by the rock. Logical.
All right, here's what I need you to do. Again? First things first.
Oh, they're going to do it again. I feel like the Dino Thunder power-up thing is actually pre-recorded. They don't do it every time now. I could be wrong. Well, at least they haven't forgotten how to fight.
I got something for you too.
Wow. Leave some for me.
Sorry, her jumps. Oh, it's classy. You turned around too soon. Although I like that they turned around like they thought he was going to blow up. Was not effective. Rider kick.
Outstanding. Let's put them together.
And they would. You would think it'd be more intense of a more intense blast, right? Maybe it was.
We rock.
So fabulous.
Fine work, team.
Will there be a Megazord battle? Yes, there will.
You both to think about what you have done. Activate.
I'm big and I'm back.
It's sword time.
Thank goodness the Brachiosaur can be activated by remote. Ooh. For a repeat appearance.
That did it.
Catch you on the flip side. Stupid Megazord.
Uh-oh.
It's Trent. He came to help us.
Wow. Now, the meteor thing is a completely new story for this, so there is not a meteor reason for the White Ranger helping them in the Sentai. But did you notice they didn't change his voice? Wow, they shot that thing through between trees and everything.
The component should still have residual powers that can help Dr. O.
How do you know this stuff?
Wait.
It's called education?
Okay, that was kind of brutal.
Back to normal.
Hey, you sound like the old Ethan.
Hey, I do.
Thank you. One more second at a shopping mall.
Let's get this rock back to the lab.
Uh-oh. This can't be good.
Here, Jesse.
We've known each other for a while now.
Sure.
Yeah, and it's pretty obvious.
So, recessive traits.
Yeah, this is true.
Yeah, so why don't we stop playing games?
She must really like him.
Devin?
Whoa!
I assume you're feeling back to normal?
Thank goodness.
I hear that.
Hey, since the meteor changed Trent to good, couldn't we use it to fight the effects of the Dino Gem?
That might work, but let's try this first.
Come on, Haley.
Activating.
Will it work? Will it work? It's working. Uh-oh. He's good to go.
Dr. O.
Awesome.
Good job, guys. Power down.
Huh?
I said power down.
Oh, that could be a problem.
I think we might have a problem.
That's what I just said. Now, in the real world, the reason for this is because part of the deal for getting JDF to come back was that he would be able to take some time off partway through the series to attend to his martial arts schools back in the States. So he has he's got quite a bit of time, several weeks anyway, where he is not going to be on the show because in real life he was back in the States taking care of his students. Eventually he will come back. And but until then, he's going to be in the suit, and then he did the ADR later on, so that he sounds like he's still there. In any event, that's going to do it for the first episode. We're going to take a quick break, and I'll be right back with episode 2.
Power Rangers Dino Thunder! We'll be back on ABC Kids. It's all new Power Rangers Dino Thunder!
That's right, you better run.
Now what's he up to?
I don't know. But we have to stop him!
Our dinosaurs! Let them go!
You scratch my back, I scratch yours.
We shall see.
It's a trap!
Punch it!
Come on! Not so fast!
Try and stop us! A new team! A fierce power! Power Rangers Dino Thunder! Don't miss this all-new episode of Power Rangers Dino Thunder! Today on ABC Kids! Power Rangers Dino Thunder is back!
All right, and we're back. We're ready to start our second episode, Burning at Both Ends. And we're going to start that here in 3, 2, 1, go. Burning at Both Ends is the 16th episode of Power Rangers Dino Thunder. It first aired on May 22nd, 2004, written by Ann Austin and directed by Andrew Merrifield. Now, Burning at Both Ends, this has an obvious meaning, but this is Power Rangers, so I'm not sure we're going to go with that one. Burning at Both Ends would tell me someone is just getting really, really tired and stressed, maybe? Possibly due to having to be a normal high school student while also being a superhero? Or maybe a teacher while also being a hero? We'll see. Oh, we're still doing this.
I thought you might like to know, I think I found a way to unfossilize Dr. Oliver, the meteor fragment.
Dr. O!
Awesome.
I said, power down!
That's not working.
I have a problem.
Dr. O, I know the suit looks good and all, but quit kidding around.
I wish I could, Kara. When Trent froze me in that amber, somehow my dino gem and my morpher must have remolecularized.
In other words,
he's stuck. And speaking of Trent, looks like he's up to no good again.
I'm so over that poser.
Go. I'll see what we can figure out here.
Why doesn't Tommy go too? It'd be interesting. Did the asteroid meteor thing completely take out his good guy's side? Oh, they're back on the Raptor Riders. Shouldn't it have been Zord time when they first showed up?
Make your move.
Now what's he up to?
I don't know, but we have to stop him.
I hate to do this to you. Nothing personal.
We need dinosaurs.
Really? Can you really call it online if he just draws them? What? Oh, giant barrels. Interesting.
What? Our dinosaurs! Let them go!
Sorry, not gonna happen.
Wait, he didn't... Oh yeah, he did capture those two.
You're out of control!
Looks more like I'm in control.
What's he gonna do with them?
What's the situation, Haley?
It's no good. He's got them in a force field. It's not Trent's fault. The gem is making him this way.
I don't care whose fault.
Also,
we find a way to deal with him, or things
in the Sentai, those little things on the barrels would cause the to blow up.
Okay, so we don't give up yet. But what do we do? Go back to school. Keep a low profile. Haley and I will let you know if anything changes.
That's what?
Has captured two of the Power Rangers auxiliary swords.
He continues to be neither with us nor against us.
I'm afraid he's kind of against you.
Such power to exist outside of my control.
We clearly share a common enemy. If only there were a way to force him to join with us.
Yes, if only.
Zeldrax, you cannot force someone to do what is not in their nature, but perhaps his
you can in Power Rangers
can be changed.
Yeah, he's a kind of bad guy now, you know.
I have a mission for you.
You know, you shouldn't walk to school alone.
Interesting.
You never know who you might run into.
See, also invisibility?
I didn't think you were the only one with Dino Gem power.
I don't want to fight.
Well, that makes one of us.
White Ranger. Dino power.
So he's been completely corrupted at this point.
That's how it has to be.
Dino Thunder!
Also, I'm kind of annoyed that two Rangers have the same power. Because isn't Tommy's power also invisibility?
Why won't you let us help you?
I don't need anyone's help. Least of all yours.
Fine, if that's how you want to play.
They're quite evenly matched here. I'm confused. When did Connor get so good? Well, okay. Nope, nope. Or is this an act? Oh!
Should I infect them both?
No, do as we've been instructed. Just the white one.
Yes, master.
What have you done?
Bad timing.
Power down.
What did he do to him?
Trent, are you okay?
Better than okay. Of me.
Huh? What?
Hey, you two.
I got an email from that science teacher of yours. He's claiming to be too sick to work.
Well, now that you mention it, he really didn't seem himself last time I saw him.
Yeah.
Well, I better not find out he's faking it, or he can kiss his job goodbye.
A model of warmth and...
Wow.
What's up?
She's a little too conversational with students.
Really? Trent? Are you in there?
Hey. It's really me.
One of Mezogog's monster attacks backfired.
I think it released the Dino Gem's hold.
That doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
Guys, look. I'm really sorry for everything I've done to you. You gotta believe it wasn't me.
Ethan's right.
If there's anything I can do to make it up to you...
How about returning our Zords for starts?
Meet me in the warehouse district this afternoon. I'll give you back your Zords. And I might have a little peace offering as well.
So they fell. Why not just do it now?
They took the bait and ran with it.
What?
Excellent. I did my part. Now you need to pay up.
Of course. I never cheat an ally.
We are not allies. It's like we said. You scratch my back, I scratch yours.
Wait.
Then we go our separate ways. That was the deal.
But how did Trent know about this plan?
We shall.
Didn't seem to know about it before the monster went out there. I'm confused.
Hey, over here.
Hope you don't mind. I tagged along just in case.
Dr. Oliver, you're okay?
More or less. I hate to get right to the point, but I don't see any Zords around here.
Good point.
Start with a peace offering I promised first.
Oh! That's a good thing Tommy showed up, otherwise it wouldn't have matched.
Who wants to try it out?
Make way!
Sorry, Ethan. I think it's better if I try it first.
Aw, man.
I mean, it's his colors.
Good work. 12-stroke engine?
Yeah, sure is.
They don't make 12-stroke engines.
Whoops!
Mezogog doesn't make monsters that turn people nice, either.
And there it goes. Can you just get off?
You pay for this. No way.
Oh, look, he's got his own. That looks fair. Oh, and there you go. Kind of use the handlebars. Turn. Oh, that worked. Oh!
Time to go to work.
So somehow by stopping it, Tommy is now in control of it. That makes... No, it doesn't make any sense. Oh, that's going to be in the intro, or if it isn't already. Oh, no, 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 no. I'm not a fan of that line. That's not good. Ooh. Ooh. That was actually pretty cool. That was... Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah.
Is that all you got?
Super Dino Mode!
Super what?
Dino Mode. Ooh.
Not this time, crazy freak.
So in Dino Mode, he can turn in midair. That's called physics defying. I kind of like that they bothered to use the Super Dino Mode in the Power Ranger footage. That's kind of nice. It's very fortunate that they have a clear path to drive in throughout this lot. Very wet, though. I thought you were for a minute there.
There's no escape. Turn and burn. Don't think I won't destroy you, Trent.
Whatever. Ooh. You say, old man. Really? He's not that old. Oh, yeah. That destroyed him. Uh-oh, something came off. Which power is this one? Hey, Tommy's back.
Careless with their toys.
You're making a mistake, Trent. Don't trust Mezagon.
Who says I do? I got what I wanted.
Wait a minute.
Goodbye, Rangers.
What about our Zords?
What's the point of this plan?
Trent, don't do this.
I'm out of here.
All he's done is give Tommy a vehicle.
Can we go over this again? Trent made a deal with Mezagon, pretending to let Insectolite turn him back into himself as a way of tricking us into taking the rigged ATV.
I can't believe he made a deal with Mezagog. That is a new low.
And risky. Trent was supposed to beat us. Mezagog's not going to be happy.
Lighting the candle at both ends, the White Ranger is bound to get burned.
And I think I'm going. The ray used
by episode title
destroyed your energy shields. I bet if you could get that creep to aim his energy buster at the Zords, we could break through Trent's shield around them.
Okay, small problem. How's Trent gonna feel about all this?
Every trap needs its bait. Trent!
Uh-oh.
Where are you?
We gotta talk, bro.
Trent!
You made a deal with Mezagog. Now it's time you made one with us.
To see me.
We wanted to make a little deal of our own.
I don't make deals with posers.
Take that back!
Uh-oh.
You just won't learn, will you?
Learn what?
The White Ranger always wins.
Go.
That was true back in MMPR.
On the other side of the warehouse.
Got it. Come on!
What is this plan? Ah. That didn't work.
You're going down. Let's help him out, guys.
That did work. Just, I like, oh, okay. I was gonna say, just stab him.
That got him.
Yeah, help me load him up.
Right, okay.
Load him up. Oh, right. Okay, now remember, in the Sentai, the plan was that they had to get to them before sunset. That's why the sunset footage.
Faster, boy! Faster!
Hang on, Zords!
We'll never make it!
We have to.
No! Let me go!
This is your cue, Insectolite. Go on. Do it.
Ooh!
You're too late.
Bunch of arrows in the back. Oh!
Oh no!
I can't be.
There. They're okay.
I survived. Whoa. Look. Huh?
But they're his now.
They switched teams.
Not a trick.
I thought they'd make a nice addition to my collection.
No way!
That's crazy!
The starfish device was just to reprogram them to obey me.
You're not gonna get away with this. Brachio!
I think that's how... Well, I think that's kind of how it worked in the Sentai 2. Turns out the starfish wasn't gonna blow him up, but was gonna just... give him control. Honestly, I don't remember.
With our Zords, he's too powerful.
Now you're beginning to get it. Why don't you just surrender the rest of your Zords to me?
If you think we'd do that, you're crazier than I thought.
Yeah.
Then I'll take them.
No!
Don't do it!
What happened? Oh!
Foolish boy. You think I would let you double-cross me?
Out of my way, insect. Drago Winger, strike mode!
No!
Another day, Rangers.
Trent has got some...
That went well.
Just give up.
Good thing I never give up.
Too easy.
Your bikes are fixed.
Yay!
Just don't do it again, okay? And as an added bonus, I reprogrammed the ATV. That should come in handy.
We're gonna need all the help we can get. If Trent and Mezogog team up for good, we're gonna have a real battle on our hands.
Why must you continue to fail at bringing me the White Ranger?
My lord. You yourself have experimented on the White Gem. Its power is unfathomable.
Excuse after excuse. Now get out of my sight. I need time to think without your sniveling incompetence distracting me.
Yes, my lord.
Oh, so kind. Why did they stay with him? Uh-oh, something's gonna happen here. No, switch him back.
Before he controls me.
Trent was there, isn't he? Yep. Ha ha ha. Alright, so there we go! In case you hadn't already figured it out, Anton Mercer and Mezogog are one and the same, sort of. There'll be more explanation of that later. So, burning at both ends! Not what I thought it would be. This one was not bad. I don't understand what the whole plan for the ATV was. I mean, all it did was give them another vehicle. I'm not sure how White Ranger and Mezogog's plan came together, because it sure didn't seem like they were working together at the beginning of the episode. I don't know. Anyway, all right, well, that's going to do it for this episode. I want to thank you all for listening. I hope you all have a wonderful next week. Next time, we'll be watching two more episodes, The Missing Bone and Bully for Ethan. Until then, take care. Hope you have a happy holiday week.
And may the power protect you.
Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com. Or feel free to leave a comment on the show's posting at powerrangerchronicles.com. Ranger Chronicles is now on Patreon. If you'd like to support the show, please visit patreon.com/rangerchronicles for more information. All images and music heard on the show are copyright the respective copyright holders and are used for entertainment purposes only. No infringement is intended. This show is dedicated to everyone, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers since 1993. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thank you, and may the power protect you.